Hi, in today's lecture, we will look into the different hitching systems and the different forces acting on tillage implements. So, primarily, there are two types of or two categories of forces acting on tillage implements or tools. So, why do we need to study about these forces? So, as engineers or as designers, we require knowledge about the forces acting on tillage implements when we need to design the tillage implement. We need to know the power requirements, we need to know the type of hitching, we need to know about the strength and rigidity of the implement, and we also need to determine the best shape of farm or tillage implement. So, in order to achieve all this, we need to know the values of the forces acting on tillage implements. So, there are different forces acting on tillage implements. It is the force of gravity, it can be the soil forces acting upon the implement, or it can be the forces acting upon the implement and the prime mover, which can either be the tractor or or animal power. So we can divide the soil reaction into two categories, or the reactive forces because of the soil on the implement. It can be categorized as useful forces and parasitic forces. So the useful forces are forces the tool must overcome in cutting or breaking and moving the soil. Parasitic forces are frictional or rolling resistant forces that act on stabilizing the surface of the that act on the stabilizing surfaces of the implement. In case of a mouldboard plow, it can be the landslide. And we can see that the operator, the one who's operating the prime mover, has control over useful forces, whereas the designer and the operator has control over the parasitic forces. So first one is the forces acting on a mouldboard plow. So there are three forces acting. We can resolve the forces acting on a mouldboard plow as horizontal, vertical, and side forces. So the horizontal is represented as L, the vertical is represented as V, and the side forces is represented as S. So the resultant of all these forces is R. So we can see here in this diagram, the resultant force R is the force from the center to the end of the cuboid, and the angle the resultant force makes with the lateral surface or the surface at the bottom is theta is phi, sorry, and the angle the resultant force makes with the vertical plane is theta. So we have resolved the components of R as R cos phi and R cos theta. Now that we know the force, the components of the resultant force R, we can resolve the components along the horizontal, the vertical, and the side directions. So from the figure which I had shown previously, the horizontal forces is R cos theta cos phi, the vertical forces are R sin theta cos phi, and the side forces are R cos theta sin phi. So P is the pulling force between the implement and the tractor in the vertical plane. So it contains only the forces acting along the horizontal and vertical directions. The side forces are not included. So P is nothing but the root of L square plus V square. So when we substitute and simplify the equation, we get P is equal to R cos theta. So P pull is nothing but the resultant force into cos of theta. Theta is nothing but the angle of inclination of the resultant force in the vertical plane with respect to the horizontal. So the next one is the forces acting on a disc plow. So the forces acting on a disc plow are on three on three axes. One is the x axis, the second one is the y axis, and the z axis. So here we can see the forces acting on the disc along all the three axes. So we have the r dash x, r dash y acting along the x and y direction, and along the z direction we can see the force r dash z. So the resultant force or the draft force is nothing but the resultant of the forces along the x and the y direction, which is r dash x and r dash y. So the resultant force is nothing but r dash xy. So now we will move on to hitching system. So hitching is nothing but the attachment of the implement to the prime mover. The prime mover can be a tractor, or if it's an animal drawn type of an implement, the animal is the prime mover. So there are different types of hitching available. We have the 2-point linkage system. We have the 3-point linkage system. We have the the power takeoff shaft connecting the tractor and the implement. So that also acts as a hitching system. So we need to know the magnitude of the resultant force. The resultant force of both the parasitic forces as well as the pull force. So the parasitic forces can be represented as Q or QV, and the pull force P or PV. So in the moldboard plow, which is attached to the a tractor or the prime mover, if they are completely a trailing type of a implement, so there are three types of mounting. We have the trailing, we have the semi-mounted and fully mounted. So if it's a completely trail type of an implement attached to the prime mover, the center of pull should be exactly behind the center of power. So in some of the previous lectures, we discussed about center of pull and center of power. So considering those definitions, we can understand that the center of pull is to be behind the center of power unit for proper hitching of trail type of implements. So there are two types of hitching: horizontal hitching and vertical type of hitching for trail type of implements. So in horizontal type of hitching, we have to determine the hitch point, which is the point where you're going to connect the implement to the prime mover. So in this case, it is a tractor. So we can see we need to fix the prime mover and the implement at the point F, which is a hitch point. So we need to know the point H, and we need to know the point center of pull in order to connect all these in a straight line, which is nothing but the line of pull. So here we need to determine the resultant point, the point where the resultant force acts for each moldboard. So in this figure, we can see it is a two bottom moldboard plow. For each moldboard, we have fixed the resultant using this dotted dot. So that is where the resultant force acts. So then we connect a straight line joining all the result the points where the resultant force acts, and we take a distance of 1/3 or 1/4 or 1/2 of the width of the plow. Here the width of the plow is the width of the cut of the plow. So when we take half or 1/3 or 1/4 of the width of the plow, and then we mark the point exactly along the line joining the resultant points, we get the point H. Now the H point is joined with the center of pull. So the line, when it cuts through the hitching, either if it's a two-point linkage or 3-point linkage system, the point where it cuts the linkage system is the point known as a hitch point F. So this is how a horizontal type of hitching is done. The next is a vertical type of hitching. In vertical type of hitching, we need to hold a rope or a string between the hitch point, the vertical hitch point, and the center of pull. We need to make sure that the bolt where the implement is to be attached to the tractor is along the line of draft or the line of pull. So here in the uppermost figure, we can see that the bolt is above the line of draft, so the implement is actually lifted at the back. And here in the second figure, we can see that the bolt is below the line of draft, and we can see the front portion of the moldboard is lifted. The last figure, we can see that the bolt or the point where the implement is attached to the tractor or the prime mover is exactly along the line of draft, and so the implement is exactly along the ground surface and at a particular depth. Now this depth is nothing but your draft or the depth of plowing. So the last figure is actually the correct way of hitching an implement to the tractor. In this case, it is a moldboard plow. Now the same thing applies, the vertical and horizontal hitching procedures apply for a disc plow also. Since a disc plow is symmetric, I have not discussed it here. A moldboard plow is asymmetric. So I have explained this here in this presentation. The same thing applies for a disc plow also. So here we can see the horizontal hitching. I have added another picture to show the horizontal hitching. So we can see the resultant acting at the point here, and We have connected the point of the resultant to the center of pull, and exactly the distance is 1 by 3 or 1 by 2 or 1 by 4. So 3 is actually the width of the cut, so we can take the 1 by 3rd or 1 by 4 or half of that distance. So if it's a two bottom plow, we join the resultant points, the points where the resultant forces acts, and then we fix the point 2. Similarly, for a three bottom plow, we fix the point 2 on the line joining the resultant forces based on the width of the cut 3. So there are a number of factors to be considered while designing the system for mounting tillage implements on rear of the tractors. So ease of attachment, the standardization to permit interchangeability, uniformity of the tillage depth, ability to obtain uniform penetration even under different or rough conditions, rapidity with which tools such as basin listers or plows enter into the ground, training characteristics of the implement along the contours, effect of implement upon the tractive ability of the tractor, especially the wheels, the transfer of the load from the front wheels to the back wheels, etc. The effect of the raised implement upon the transport stability of the tractor. So the next is the three-point hitching system. So the three-point hitching system is a system where there are two links at the bottom and one link at the top. And so there are standard specifications available for three-point hitching. And we can choose any type of hitching based upon the power available, the drawbar power available from the prime mover. So in this case, it is a tractor. So the power drawn from the tractor can be used to determine what type of hitching can be done. The next is automatic draft control. In nowadays, the tractors are fitted or employed with the automatic draft control system, where there is a draft sensing or depth sensing inbuilt in the tractor. So when implements are attached, automatic draft control can be achieved. So horizontal or vertical type of hitching methods need not be necessarily done in tractors, this automatic draft control system will automatically fix the required depth of penetration of the implement in the field. So the upper link is generally used for the draft sensing or in the automatic draft control system. So the upper link is one which is always in compression when the implement is in the ground. So it is always in a compressed state. It is fixed. So the upper link doesn't move. The bottom two links only move along the sides. The upper link is used for fixing the depth. So the measurement of the implement draft equation, as I've already discussed in the previous lectures, is given here in this slide. Using this equation, I have given a problem to be solved. So find out the horsepower developed by a pair of bullocks in pulling a UP number 2 plow at the forward speed of 3 kilometers per hour. The plow makes a furrow 20 centimeters wide and 11 centimeters deep. The dynamometer indicates an average draft of 85 kgf, and what will be the new unit draft. So the total draft is given. We need to calculate the unit draft and also the horsepower. So unit draft is nothing but the total draft by the cross section of the furrow. Now the furrow is a rectangular furrow wide, 20 centimeters wide and 11 centimeters deep. So using the fourth equation, the total draft by cross section, unit cross section, we can calculate the unit draft. Now to determine the horsepower developed, we can use the power equation. So the horsepower is equal to draft into the distance moved per second or the speed divided by 75. So we can calculate the horsepower in HP. A similar problem is given here for practice. Thank you.